Dit is Papa Alpha 0 Echo Tango Echo voor de Daily Minutes met een nieuwsupdate voor vandaag. 21 februari 2016, ik heb de verkeerde datum voor me. Dit is het bulletin van zondag. Today's bulletin is always in weekends, will be in English. At the end of the bulletin there will be our Morse code words in different speeds and right after that a small SSTV image in BW8. We start now with some news of WIA.
From Australia, this is VK1WIA.
The radio voice of a century. Fred Crockford, who lives in the borough of Brentwood, recently told his local newspaper in the UK, "I've been retired longer than some people have been at work." With more, courtesy Amateur Radio Newsline, here is RSGB newsman Jeremy Boot, G4NJH.
In fact, Fred, G6YUY, has also likely been on the air longer than many people have been on the planet. The retired trolley bus driver first went on the amateur bands in the 1920s, when radio operations were governed, he said, by the post office. Now he's not just a licensed ham, but a centenarian ham, having just celebrated his 100th birthday. He said radio had made every one of his many days an adventure, and he told the newspaper, "The fun is the surprise discovery of who is available to talk to from anywhere in the world." He said, "We talk to whoever happens to be out there on that particular spot and at that particular moment." A 70-foot-long horizontal aerial carries his voice everywhere, even to Australia. Fred told the newspaper he still sets aside about 2 hours every evening to reach out via radio to the world, and whether he lands in the United States, New Zealand or Australia, the thrill of DXing is no less a thrill to him at 100 than it was when he was a young man.
It seems that at 100 years of age, his most treasured birthday gift of all has been the gift of time.
Rewind.
Here is Bob VK6POP, the president of the West Australian Amateur Radio News.
Amateur radio news broadcasts in Western Australia first went to air on 80 metres in 1931. Counting on my fingers, that was 85 years ago. Such an anniversary and marriage would warrant gifts of diamonds and sapphires, but alas, in modern radio, we don't even have a crystal to celebrate with. The Wireless Institute began in Western Australia in 1913. Our story begins 16 years later, when the Institute moved into new headquarters in William Street, Perth, and began setting up the VK6WI station, completed in February 1930. The antenna was a Zeppelin style. The early days of amateur radio involved a working relationship with early broadcasters. In fact, many amateurs were also broadcasters. There are reports of amateur radio transmitters being used to broadcast entertainment. The first mention I can find of an amateur radio news broadcast is from Perth's Daily News newspaper on Monday the 23rd of March in 1931, and that says, "The Institute's transmitter VK6WI will go on the air on phone on Saturday evening, March the 28th, using the 80 metre band. This will be a test transmission in preparation of the dissemination of Institute news to country members, technical lectures to members, and the testing of the set for phone and demonstration of the principles involved for members preparing for their AOCP certificates." There's not much information about the continuing history of amateur radio news broadcasts. However, it picked up after the end of the war in 1945 through to the present day. WA Amateur Radio News was formed as a club in 2014, with its principal activity being the production of the News West Amateur Radio News and broadcasting it along with the WIA National News. Amateur Radio News in Western Australia has evolved from a single live broadcast on Saturday nights to broadcasts on Sundays at five different times on several bands from 160 metres through to 23 centimetres, including a linked repeater network covering much of the southwest of the state. There are links to informative websites in the text edition of the news. Although we at WA Amateur Radio News can't take credit for 85 years of amateur radio news broadcast in this state, we can be confident that we're well on the way to ensuring its long-term future. Now, about those diamonds and sapphires.
Welcome to the TX Talk podcast of the GB2RS National News. And now the DX News, compiled from 425 DX News and other sources. Masato, Juliet, Alpha, Zero, Romeo Quebec Victor will be active as Sex Yankee 5 / Juliet Alpha Zero Romeo Quebec Victor, mainly from his hotel in Kingston, Jamaica. That's November Alpha 097 on the IOTA codes, starting on the 21st of February until the 17th of April. Activity will be mostly on the weekend and spare time, hopefully in the beach area and not in his hotel room. He'll work the 10 to 160 meter bands using CW and SSB, and you can QSL via Mike Zero, Oscar, X-Ray, Oscar, or via OQRS or Logbook of the World. Members of the Radio Club Argentino will be on the air from the Carlini base in the South Shetland Islands during the last few weeks of February. They'll be signing Lima Uniform 1 Zulu India, and the IOTA reference there is Alpha November 010. Members of the Italian de-expedition team will be active as 3 X-Ray Yankee 1 Tango from Los Islands, that's Alpha Foxtrot 051. Until the 4th of March, they'll be on all bands from 160 metres to 6 metres on SSB, CW and RITI. Mark Kilo Zero Mike Delta Juliet is on the air as 9 Hotel 3 Delta Juliet until the 1st of June while on a business trip to Malta. Activities in his spare time using mostly SSB on 17 meters, and the IOTA code at Malta is Echo Uniform 023. QSL to his home call. A team of 9 operators from North America will be active as Alpha 35 Tango from the island of Tonga until the 28th of February. QSLs will all be handled by Mike Zero Uniform Romeo X-Ray. And a number of American operators will be QRV from Guantanamo Bay, that's November Oscar 15, until the 4th of March. Look out for the call signs Kilo Golf 4 Bravo Papa, Kilo Golf 4 Echo Uniform, Kilo Golf 4 Hotel Foxtrot, Kilo Golf 4 Hotel Papa, and Kilo Golf 4 Whiskey Victor.